Hi, I'm Lauren McLarney, Government Affairs Specialist at the National Federation of the Blind. We asked the public, what about technology in the classroom and how do you think it impacts students with disabilities?
I think with technology today that it would be a lot easier for students who are blind to use technology.
I think with technology nowadays, it's so advanced that it could be a great benefit to people with disability.
I would hope it's made it easier for them. That should be the case.
I think developing technology can help blind people and other people with disabilities, but it's still developing. You never know what could happen.
We video conference blind students from across the country to find out what's their reality.
It was my belief in high school that technology would bridge the gap between blindness and the rest of the sighted world.
Jamie Principato, physics major.
In general, I found that while technology, I still believe, has the potential to bridge the gap between blindness and the rest of the sighted world, it's not being used to do that.
I've been blind since birth. Bam, exclamation point.
John Whalen, Ivy Leaguer.
In a lot of ways, technology was this thing that was supposed to be freeing and solving a lot of problems, but it's just introduced a whole slew of additional problems that I'm now trying to find workarounds for. In the initial promise of equal access and easy access, at least in my life, I haven't seen it come to fruition.
A lot of the coursework that's posted is inaccessible to me.
Deja Powell, PhD candidate.
And so that becomes problematic. And for a long time, I would have to submit that to the disability office. They would have to translate it and get it back to me, but then it ended up taking too long. Our classes are in 1 week units. So if I get behind at all, I'm in trouble.
The level of accessibility and usability depends on the product and the software that you're using.
Gabe Cazares, Texas Co-Ed.
I know that at my institution, simple things like printing out a document are inaccessible to blind students.
For me, it's a matter of staying up with my peers.
I often have to find workarounds with professors, other ways I can contribute to these discussions.
It was uncomfortable and it didn't create for a very healthy learning environment, so we both decided that we needed to transfer.
Can you imagine what it must be like to be like these students? How well do you think you would do in college if you were denied access to the materials?
All right, class, please take out your e-readers.
Students take out e-readers. Sean looks puzzled.
All right, guys, let's open up our lab software.
Students open laptop. After fiddling, Sean looks frustrated.
Luckily, it doesn't have to be that way. Federal law requires schools to only use technology that is fully accessible to students with disabilities, and it's actually really easy to make electronic instructional material accessible. If that's the case then, so what's the disconnect? Why are so many students like Gabe, Deja, Jamie, and Sean facing all of these barriers? Because there are no guidelines, there's no criteria, there's no specifics telling schools, here's what accessibility looks like, here's what you need to ask for from the manufacturer. The Technology Education and Accessibility in College and Higher Education Act fills in the gaps. The TEACH Act authorizes the creation of voluntary accessibility guidelines and then incentivizes schools to only use technology that conforms to those guidelines with a safe harbor from litigation. Guidelines are a simple solution that benefits everyone. Without guidelines, schools will continue to be non-compliant, and that means more lawsuits. And without guidelines, students with disabilities will continue to be left behind by the very technology that should have ensured their full participation. The TEACH Act rectifies all of this without creating any mandates on manufacturers and without creating any new requirements for schools. Just listen to these other stakeholders, like Lucy Franz from the University of Montana and Alan Adler from the Association of American Publishers.
Providing access to all students. It's a good strategy. Give them the information that they need. I mean, it's not easy for universities with limited resources to know everything and have a plan on how to proceed with this relatively difficult problem.
So we think that it would be very helpful, not only for publishers, but for the people who manufacture the devices. If there could be some consistent guidelines that indicated when those devices were able to provide access to content in a way that is accessible for people with print disabilities.
In just the Senate alone, the TEACH Act is sponsored by Senators Elizabeth Warren and Orrin Hatch. Our first co-sponsors were Democrat Michael Bennett and Republican Kelly Ayotte. Our newest supporters are Ed Markey and Marco Rubio. Since when have these two ever seen eye to eye on anything? Bipartisan support, check. The Teach Act has been endorsed by almost every major stakeholder group. The American Association of People with Disabilities, the National Association of the Deaf, the Homeschool Legal Defense Association, the Association of American Publishers, the Association on Higher Education and Disability, National Center for Learning Disability,
American Council of the Blind,
Association for Education,
National Council of the
Association of
Pastors,
Georgia's
National
Council on Rehabilitation and Education. That's pretty much everyone. Endorsements. Check. In 2008, Congress authorized the Advisory Commission on Accessible Instructional Materials in Postsecondary Education for Students with Disabilities. Their report concluded with 19 recommendations, and recommendation number one says, Congress should authorize the United States Access Board to establish guidelines for accessible instructional materials that will be used by government, in the private sector, and in post-secondary academic settings. So exactly what the Teach Act does, and not just any recommendation. Recommendation number one. Data. Check. Change.org had a petition about the Teach Act asking members of Congress to co-sponsor the bill. It was signed by over 160,000 people. That's a lot of people. Public support. Check. There's only two things standing in our way, the higher education lobby and Congress. The higher education lobby might be difficult, but they can be reasoned with. And Congress might move slow, but they'll listen to their constituents. Help us pass the Teach Act. Take action now. And honestly, blind students can't afford to wait.
I feel like I have equal intelligence to my sighted peers, and sometimes I can't showcase that.
I want Congress to pass the Teach Act because this is personal to me.
It basically spells out exactly what accessibility is meant to look like.
The Teach Act would honestly reduce a lot of the work for the college.
Set some guidelines about what needs to be done to make things accessible right off the bat.
I wish that universities would understand that when they deploy an accessible technology or software, they're showing the weaknesses of students with disabilities.
It's basically telling the student that, yeah, you can attempt to learn this material and learn this concept that you're going to need for your career, but we're only going to show you bits and pieces of it. The rest of it we're reserving for your sighted peers.
I want Congress to pass the Teach Act so that students who are in my position 5 years down the road don't have to face the same difficulties that other blind students and disabled students can have equal and timely access to all their materials.
Senator Elizabeth Warren.
It's not enough to say to our students, we're trying to make college accessible, but when you get here, you're not going to be able to deal with the materials.
To learn more about the Teach Act, visit www.nfb.org/teach.